Sports Medicine is the most trusted of its kind in Northeast Indiana. That's because of the benefits our services provide you. We serve every level of athlete with our sports nutritionist, the expert physicians at ONE, the area's only specialized athletic rehab, and the region's industry leader in sports performance, AWP. The roster coordinates your care in state-of-the-art facilities conveniently located in your community. To start your journey, visit us at parkviewsportsmedicine.com.
Again, if this game is anything like the way she sang the national anthem, this will be a blockbuster because that was a beautiful national anthem. And I love when they do it live.
It's tough to get there. I used to sort of sing. It hurts. The crowd went, ooh, all at the same time. That was neat. That was just flat neat. Still got goosebumps. And you know what I didn't see? I didn't see anybody around here taking a knee.
No, that's good.
You ain't kidding, because I put the headphones down, you'd be busy for a minute, and I go jerk them up off the floor. That's one thing I will not put up with. First quarter action is going to come shortly. They're going to introduce the starting lineups. We cheated. We got them a little bit early. So we're going to talk about our first quarter sponsor a little bit here. It's Holy Cross College. And they're proud to bring you the first quarter of tonight's game. Holy Cross College is an affordable Catholic college offering a life-changing, life-affirming education, and it's closer than you think. It's just 2 hours away. You can search for them on the web at Holy Cross College at NotreDame.com.
Kenny, if you want, I can start with Homestead. Jack Ferguson, number 10, 6'3", senior. Very, very good outside shooter. Parker Mangus, number 20, 6'3", senior. Jake Archibald, going to be a guard, 6', only a freshman. I think Luers will want to try to put a little pressure on him, see if he can handle the ball. Sam Buck, 6'5", a junior. Good inside-outside player. And the strength of the team on the inside, Brandon Durnell, he also can go outside and shoot it, 6'6". They start 3 seniors, a junior, and a freshman. They go 6'6", 6'5", 6'3", 6'3", 6'. A lot of size and a lot of experience for Homestead.
The starting lineup for the Bishop Luers Knights, Trey Underwood, a 6'3". They're listing him as a forward. He's a senior, and he is a wide body, strong player on the inside. J.J. Foster. He's 5'11 guard. He can shoot from the parking lot. We've seen him do it the last couple 3 years. Ray Walker Jr., second year of the Bishop Luers Knights. He's 5'10", and he's got shoes that blaze. That young man is quick on quick, as Bob likes to say. I'm really interested in watching the freshman, Jalen Cowsey, number 22, the 5'9 guard. And anywhere in the city, if you're a freshman or you're a starter, you got to be pretty good. And Anton Berry, he stands 6'5". He's been playing lights out on the inside for the Bishop Luers Knights. The coach, J.J. Foster's crew, goes, 6'3", 5'11", 5'9", 5'10", and 6'5". So you're right, they're giving up some height, but I think we've got some strength and some quickness, and the teams are hitting the floor, and we're going to start here, Pete, DQ.
It'll be interesting, Kenny, again, how the referees, I hope they let him play a little. Foul trouble, I know Luers has only got five other guys on the bench. They got 12 listed, but only five more addressed. So they can't get into foul trouble, especially they got to keep Berry out of trouble, and Homestead's got to keep Durnell out of foul trouble.
And those are the two guys jumping center. The whistle is blown. The ball's in the air. Tip controlled by the Bishop Luers Knights. Hustled down there by Ray Walker Jr. He's going to dribble over the timeline. And Homestead starts out in a man-to-man, guarded by Jack Ferguson. Throw back at the top of the key. Swing it back to Walker. Walker gets inside. No good. Trey Underwood with a tip back. No good. Barry Grinnell fights for the rebound. Knock off of Grinnell's hand. Luers is going to retain possession. So we are off and running, Bob.
And we got the battle of the cheering sections. Homestead Luers are going at it. They all got their Christmas ugly sweaters on, it looks like, Kenny. So this should be an interesting ball game.
J.J. Foster tries to get on the inside. Almost got his pocket picked. Recovered and hands it off to Walker. Walker's going to float to the left side.
Durnell is trying to guard Antoine Berry.
And Walker's going to call for traveling. He lost the handle on the way up. He had a spin move. He got Ferguson leaning to the left. He's going to spin to the right. He got so excited he lost handle on the basket.
Here comes how some of the game will be determined with the press.
Luers put on the press. They broke it nicely, but they got somebody trapped on the baseline. Baseline pass to the left side. Shot no good. Berry, last guy to. Ooh, they give us the basketball. That was interesting. Now must have popped it out of Barry's hands. Three was no good and rattled around and came straight down. So all the bigs were after that rebound. And it ends up going Bishop Luers' way.
Looks like Walker's the point guard, and they're going to have Foster run off screens. He'll like that three-point shot from the corner or at the top of the key.
Foster finds Barry at the top of the key. Barry says, thank you. He'll put it up. Nice little face. Got it. First
when your leading scorer can hit a three, that could be trouble for Homestead all night because he's also strong inside.
First points of the game go to the Bishop Luers Knights. Homestead, Ferguson brings over the timeline. Or Mangus did, excuse me, he flips it over to Buck. Buck finds Grinnell, back to Buck. Buck drives the baseline, cut off nicely by the defense, and Grinnell in the corner. Buck swings back out the top of the key. They swing it around on Parker Mangus with the
Coach
basketball.
Johnson hollering out signals.
Trying to give it to Jack Ferguson, he still don't have it, so Mangus still has the ball. Bounce pass over to Archibald. Archibald outside the arc, right side. Think about going baseline, he bounce passes to Grinnell, he's guarded by Underwood. They throw it across court, top of the key. Oh, the lane opened up. Layup, no good. Barry fighting for the rebound, and we're going to say it's Homestead basketball.
That's two or three times Luers has had their hands on the ball. Barry, they got to really grab that sucker, but a lot of battling on the rebounds.
Mangus didn't finish either. Mangus or Archibald down on the inside. And I love basketball. The cheering sections are going crazy already, and it's really early. They get it to Durnell. He tries to baseline under. Whatever will cut him off. He got nowhere to go. Finally, someone comes over and relieves him. Ferguson has it guarded by Walker.
Tight defense by Luers. Great man-to-man.
And they get it out at the top of the key. Durnell goes around Underwood. Shot up, no good, and I think Underwood's going to get called for the foul. He ended up a step behind on that play. That's the first whistle of the ballgame at 6-0-2 in the first.
Durnell, 6'6", very strong. But when you can put the ball on the floor like he can and go to the basket and also shoot from the outside, that could cause Luers problems all night, and Underwood's trying to guard him, and that's his first foul.
And Durnell missed his first free throw, so the score is still 3-0. Baseball score here at 6-0-2 in early first quarter action. Bob Mers and Kenny Barr having a good time. Second free throw looks like it was supposed to go in, went in nice and smooth. So 3-1 your score. Foster brings the basketball up this time for the Knights. And he shoots one from downtown. No good rebound. Easily pulled out of there by Mangus of Homestead. He finds, I think, Ferguson. He's going to slowly bring the basketball up. Ferguson,
he's the shooter. Causey's on him. They got to make Ferguson. They can't let him get hot.
Durnell has the top of the key. Swings over the left side to Ferguson. Ferguson back to Mangus. Mangus over to Durnell. Durnell, 12-footer online, but short. No good. Barry gets it released out to Foster. Foster finds Underwood. Underwood all by himself under the basket.
Durnell did not get down the floor, and that was his man, and Underwood beat him down the floor.
Absolutely. 5-1. Luers on top by 4. 5-18. Over the timeline goes Durnell handling the basketball. Kind of surprise there. Hands it off to Parker. Mangus. Send it to the right side to Ferguson. Ferguson double teamed by the guards. He carried it. Put it on his hip and put his hand underneath the ball a little bit too far. And, you know, they get away with that a lot compared to what we did younger.
Luers' defense is causing some problems for Homestead. They haven't seen this tight of defense all year, and Luers is really tenacious on the defensive end.
Marie Walker Jr. bounce pass over to the freshman, Cowsey. Cowsey, not much heard from yet. Gives it to Barry at the top of the key. Back to Cowsey. He's, 12 feet outside right, high right wing. Kind of sizing up the defense a little bit. Gets to Walker. Walker finds Barry. Barry guarded man-to-man by Durnell. He gets inside, tries to throw it over the top, and Ferguson stole the basketball.
Oh, nice move.
And in, coast to coast for Jack Ferguson, the Homestead Spartans. Quickly over the timeline, Foster banged in too hard that time by Jake Archibald, the freshman. Tried to prevent him from getting inside the lane, and he did exactly that, and he picked up the personal foul. First foul of the ball game against the Homestead Spartans, so of course it's the first one against Archibald, the freshman. And the Knights are going to take the basketball out far side of the floor on the side. Walker can trigger it into Barry. Barry just flips it back to Walker. Going to reset the offense. Barry finds himself with the high right toe. Cowsey has the rock. And he did the freshman thing. Traveled a little bit. And, of course, they hang the ball. Look at the referee going, me? And the answer is yes. You did travel. So Homestead has the ball. Full court press put on again by the Bishop Luers Knights. Inbound pass get in, then they're going to relax and pick it up at half court. Walker on Ferguson. Ferguson on a quick handoff to Archibald. He runs the handoff over to Mangus. Three on the way.
You got to watch him, Kenny, because he can do that all night.
Ferguson with the three on the left wing, put it up and in. 6-5 Homestead. They're on a little 6-0 run here, or 5-0 run, actually. Calvin with the basketball, throws it to Walker Jr. Ray Walker Jr. puts the ball on his left hip.
Archibald, the freshman's trying to watch Foster, and that could be a mismatch for Luers.
Cowsey snaps it back to Walker, back to Cowsey. Cowsey thinking about it, looked at the defense, bounce pass down to Barry. Barry, baseline jumper, no good. Rebound Mangus of Homestead, gets it forward to Archibald. Archibald catches two first. That was almost over and back. He almost didn't get there. Three on the way from the right side, no good. Durnell, the long rebound. Pulls it out, flips it to the top of the key, swinging around to Shell Ferguson with a three on the way. Count it, same place he just hit the last one.
He's got 8 points and two or threes.
9-5 Homestead, 3:16 on the clock, first period action. J.J. Foster tries to get inside, got his pocket pick. Ferguson with the basketball, he's going inside, and lots of white jerseys prevent him from even getting close to the iron. And we'll see who the foul call. It could be one of three people that was inside there. I think they're going to call it on J.J. Foster. That's his first in the ballgame. A non-shooting foul. Ferguson going to take the basketball out of bounds.
Jason Davis, a 6'5 senior's in. Can he give him a little more size?
Ferguson puts it up.
Somebody
there.
Better slow this kid down. He's got four baskets and three of them are three. He's got 11 and Homestead's got 12.
This one was from the right side. Just about the same angle as he made the two on the left side. Give the basketball to Walker. Walker to Davis, Davis to Cowsey. Cowsey, again, sizing up the defense. I think he's wanting to drive, but he's just kind of biding his time. Walker, he's going to put up a three, partially deflected by the Homestead defense. And Parker Mangus gets it forward quickly to Buck. Buck throws it away, and it's grabbed by Jason Davis. He gets it to Walker. Walker uses the speed.
That's what he's got to do.
Up. No good. Four Spartans around the rebounding. They get it to Ferguson. Ferguson puts a
what
head
a move.
Fake, dumps it off. Mangus, count it. Parker Mangus with his first bucket of the ball.
Homestead's
game.
A good-looking start here for them at 14-5, and Luers was taking it to them the first couple minutes.
They are on a 13-0 run, and Coach Foster says, I've seen enough of that. Let's take a 30-second break ourselves. You're listening to 106.3 WRDF, Northeast Indiana.
Shawnee Construction and Engineering is proud to support tonight's game. We specialize in commercial and industrial construction and use unique life cycle principles to provide our clients the highest quality craftsmanship for the life of the project. Shawnee Construction and Engineering are partners with you for lifetime savings. We can be found at shawneeconstruction.com or at 260-489-1234. That's 260-489-1234.
And we're back, basketball fans. 2:18 to go. First period action, 14-5. Homestead up by 9 after a nice 5-1 start. By
I am surprised, Kenny, that Foster and Walker, when we watched them last year, especially Walker, he was good at driving to the basket. And Homestead, and now Homestead has taken that away from him.
J.J. Foster with the basketball, looking right into the fence with Grant Raber, who got in. The freshman on the long cross-court pass puts it up. No good. Rebound Homestead. Homestead wants to run, which is exact opposite what I thought was going to happen. Ferguson finally ran into a wall. Durnell's going to put up a three. Rebound hits the floor one time. J.J. Foster gets it, runs between his legs, and heads down the other end of the floor. Thinking about doing it all himself, he has to dump it off the walk because three Spartans close the lane on him.
They got to try to get the ball back to Barry. He's doing all the scoring right now for him.
Davis. Walker thinks about it. Shot fake, didn't do much with it. Gives it to Cowsey. Cowsey over to Davis. He's got to throw it around the shell. Into Berry. Berry's at the right toe. Double team. Hands it to Davis. Top of the key. They swing it over the left corner to Walker. Walker trying to get it inside to Berry. Berry guarded by Janelle. That's a matchup Bob and I talked about earlier. Berry, quick move to the inside.
Oh, that's a big one. Big play by Antoine Berry. And he can get a basket maybe and the free throw.
He caught the defender off guard. He spun to his left with a really quick first step. And Alex Nearer checks into the lineup for Bishop Luers. He's going to spell the freshman, Cowsey.
He's a six-foot senior.
And Berry, who broke the drought for the Bishop Luers Knights, comes home with the old-fashioned three-point play, and that will help the Knights a little bit at 14-8 now the score.
And he has six of Luers' 8 points, so Homestead's got to slow him down.
107 on the clock. Ferguson brings it over the timeline slowly, but they quickly run a weave at the top of the key. Get to Grant Raver. Raver dumps it off to Brunel. Brunel lines up a three. It's no good. Rebound at J.J. Foster, but the defense hustled back. He wanted to go, but didn't. Near to Berry in the corner. Berry jacks it up. No good. Rebound. Ferguson up there. A little wild, but he got it.
Drives. You're right about them running.
Brunel, baseline jumper. Count it.
He's had most of his shots from the outside, which surprised me, Kenny. So you and I are right. We're a little confused by how Homestead's playing, but they're playing well.
They got the ball to Berry. He was way outside, but he was fouled by Parker Mangus. His first foul of the ball game. That's three on Homestead. And the Spartans run a couple of bodies in.
One of them,
Logan and Sam Buck back in the lineup, I believe.
And he's got some good size for Homestead.
You get it into Alex Nearer, 6 foot guard. He tried to get into Berry. It's deflected. Homestead comes out of the pack with it. Ferguson with a basketball guarded by Walker. Ferguson head fake goes to the right side. Walker keeps up with it. Berry jumps, alters the shot, gets the rebound. Here come the Knights with 16 seconds to go. Walker tries to blow by the defense. Brunel does a good job. Head fake.
Good defense by Homestead.
Give it to Davis on the outside. No rotation on the ball. Hits the iron, kind of dives. Rebound Homestead. 5 seconds to go. They look up, and Ferguson floats down the floor. They got a three it launched, and it's good if it goes, but it does not hit anything but nothing. And 16-8 is going to be your first quarter score. If you're listening to Redeemer Radio on 106.3 FM, WRDF, Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
Our hope grows as we anticipate the coming of Jesus during this Advent season. We continue to act in charity to spread the faith through the organizations we support. Redeemer Radio is a resource that helps turn the listener towards Christ. Maybe your life has been impacted by a message that you hear. Pass that gift along and share the message with others through your charitable gift. As you make choices about your giving during December, please prayerfully consider a gift of hope to Redeemer Radio.
Think of Briscoe Dentistry for your family's dental care. Dr. Todd Briscoe and team know that your body is more than just teeth and gums. Your oral health affects the performance ability of your entire body. And on the field or court, you want your body to perform at its best. So trust Dr. Briscoe and team to provide the ultimate in preventative, periodontal, orthodontic, restorative, and cosmetic dentistry. To optimize your body's performance, contact Dr. Briscoe at 260-486-9950 or on the web at briscoedentistry.com.
Okay, the second quarter is about to start. 16-8, your score. And Homestead will have the basketball.
Kenny, they have six baskets, and three of them are threes. They have 9 points on threes, and Luers only has eight in the whole game.
To get it into Donnell, he hands it off to Ferguson. Ferguson hands the ball, slings it to the right side. Up to Buck. Buck is going to run the baseline. They sling the ball around the shell, and hand it off to Raver. Raver is fouled on the reach in, probably by J.J. Foster. Trying to disrupt that handoff. That man-to-man mini weave that a lot of teams like to run to pop somebody free. And run well, it works well.
Ray Walker is trying to guard Ferguson. He had 11 points in the first quarter.
J.J., second foul of the ballgame. He's going to have a seat in the freshman and back in the lineup. For
now Luers is really small, Kenny, with Causey in there, and near is 6 foot, and Causey's only 5'9".
Sam Buck takes the basketball in the backcourt, brings it into the forecourt, flips it to the right side to Ferguson. The five count has started, and Ferguson finally puts the ball on the floor, waiting for the screen to Grinnell. They tried to pick and roll, didn't work. But Grinnell down the baseline, guarded by Berry. Long cross-court pass over the top to Buck. Buck drives, stops, floats, puts it up, no good. Berry with a rebound, gets it forward to Causey. Causey looks for help, he gets it to Davis right side, hands it off to Berry. Berry comes floating over the timeline. Good little Walker. Walker gets it down inside to Berry, taking a spot on the post. He kicks it outside and steps out of bounds.
I think he's trying to do a little too much right now. Anton Berry's a good player and trying to get the offense going, but he can't do it by himself. That's five turnovers for Luers.
Well, he got in between Buck and Drunell, and there's a couple of big boys there to
And as around. You said, Kenny, they are playing very good on the defensive end, Homestead.
Logan Pauley brings the basketball over the timeline for the Homestead Spartans. Bounce pass to Drunell, who's right at the top of the key. Slings it to the right side to Sam Buck. Buck. Pauley. Pauley gets it back over in the corner. Raver.
Nice dribble pass.
Tries to get inside to Ferguson, who made a nice back cut. Berry recovered and slapped the ball out of bounds, but just barely.
Homestead is like their girls, the boys. They never stop. They're always moving, constant movement, and Coach Johnson's got to be happy with his offensive movement right now.
Long inbound pass goes to Ferguson. He stops everything and points to the couple spots on the floor. People get where they want to. Ferguson gets it back, and bang, he was 6-7 feet outside. That was almost an NBA three.
He's got 14 points, and four of them are threes.
Three on the way from the other end from Luers. That's no good. Rebound, Homestead. Homestead looks to run. Luers gets back on defense that time. Long shot by Alex Neer. I think that's his first shot of the ball game. Didn't go anywhere. Ferguson beats the defender, kicks it out. Three on the way. Oh, it looked like I shot it. It was terrible. Causey with a rebound. Ball hit somebody's foot. So shooting down the floor. And they're going to call a foul on the back of the play on Homestead. Going to see who that's on. 6:06 on the clock, 19-8. Homestead beating Luers currently by 11.
I think you are too, Kenny. I'm very surprised with Luers' proficiency on offense to only have 8 points here almost a quarter into the second quarter here.
Neer with the basketball gets it over to Walker. Walker to Neer, and Neer gets it to Davis baseline. Davis gets it inside to Berry. He has triple teamed to kick it to the outside to Causey. Causey drives it inside, bounce past to Berry, who snuck back and got himself free. Rebound the freshman. Causey pulls it out of there. They're going to reset the offense. Berry, left toe. Wants to drive around.
Oh, nice move.
Put it up, and too strong off the glass. No good. Rebound Raber for Homestead. He gets it forward to Buck. Buck thought about it, and Davis cut him off at the half. And Ferguson got a little lazy. Called for traveling. Mangus and Archibald back in the lineup for Homestead. And Trey Underwood. Not a lot of buzzers. They're going to let Trey in or not?
I'm trying to see who he came in for.
Well, nobody yet, it looks like. J.J. Foster going to check in the lineup. Oh, and Trey's going to take the ball out of bounds. The Foster in for Neer. Underwood in for
Davis.
Would it be?
Oh, okay.
Davis is down, hiding on the baseline behind Ferguson over there. So Ray Walker going to bring the basketball up. The Knights got to get going on offense. They've got 8 points here at 5:19 in the second. Davis.
They might have to jack up a three just to loosen it up inside on
Or they could do
good
that.
Play,
nice back cut. But Davis put an easy one in, and a nice heads-up pass and assist by Ray Walker Jr. that time. Well, Mangus Parker Mangus with the basketball.
Oh, good. Good Foster. Steal by Foster. That'll get. Oh, that's intentional. That's got to be intentional.
You think so, because Jake Arkansas.
I sure would think so, put it that way.
And J.J. Foster, coach, has got his arms crossed asking for it.
Wow. I guess he did get the ball, but I thought that was an intentional foul.
Well, it certainly was intentional in theory, but physically he got enough of the ball where they're only going to give him a two-shot foul. That is his second foul of the ball game. Jake Archibald, the freshman for Homestead.
This might get Bishop Luers going a little. J.J. Foster has to get his name in the scorebook, and that'll really get his game going.
And he missed the first one. Buck's going to come back in the lineup for Archibald. Archibald with two fouls is probably done for this half. 4:55 on the clock, 19-10. The Knights down by nine. They'd like to make it eight here. And Foster eyes, flies, and drains it. The 19-11. Cousy in, Foster out. As Everybody decides where they're going to go. Looks like the Knights are going to go back to the full court press at least.
And we thought that full court press, Kenny, would make a difference and cause some problems. And so far it is, and Luers has got to try to get some points off of their press, I would think.
Grant Rayburn picks the basketball up in the backcourt. That's never a good idea. He finds Parker, Mangus. Mangus gets it to Buck. Buck's going to launch a three. Hits the back of the iron and flies all the way back to him. Three bodies fly out of bounds. And the call goes to Bishop Luers.
Good hustle by Bishop Luers.
Not so sure they didn't get a call there, Bob.
Yeah.
Because Davis out-hustled both of them. Housie back out and J.J. Foster back in. So it was a coaching moment there for J.J. Foster. Coach probably told him to shoot the basketball.
Foster and has to get his game going. And also Ray Walker hasn't scored yet either.
And Walker got the rock. He's going to launch a three.
That's what they need, and he can do that. You let him shoot, he can shoot Luers right back in this game, which he just did.
Wasn't the prettiest of three, but it went in, so that's all that matters.
Homestead hasn't scored this quarter.
Mangus picks up his dribble, has to give it off to Durnell. Durnell's got Underwood on him, tries to go to the inside. Buck running the baseline to get the ball to him, but he can't do anything with it. To Mangus, out to Raver. Raver tries to drive, he's cut off. Over to Durnell, and they get it over to Mangus. Mangus gets it back to Durnell, same thing. They're trying that back cut, and Luers is wise to that play as Ferguson was covered well on the interior pass.
Homestead has not scored. Coach Johnson does not like what he's seeing. He's been outscored 6-0 here, and all of a sudden his lead's down to 5.
Let's take a quick 30-second break as they call timeout on the floor. You're listening to Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM, Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
Hi, Charlie Momper here from Momper Insulation. It's never too late to add insulation. You'll be amazed at the results when our Momper professionals retrofit your walls and attics with high-quality insulation. When we're finished, you'll stay warmer and hopefully save money on your heating bills as well. Momper, the number one name in insulation since 1956. Call today at 432-7543.
3:53 left to go in the second quarter, and the Redeemer Radio Odyssey Travel, their second quarter sponsor. They're interested in traveling to the Holy Land of 2017 to learn more about our first International Odyssey at an information session at St. Elizabeth and Seton Parish on Wednesday, January 18th at 6 p.m. Learn about Odyssey. Ask your question to save your seat on the plane. Can't wait to travel with you. Homestead drives up in. Foul. We'll make it 21-14.
Grant Raber, 5'10 junior, but boy, he sure drove hard and strong to the basket, didn't he?
He sure did. Went in there with confidence. He was fouled that time by J.J. Foster. That's his third of the half. I was really surprised to see him come back that quick. And Dad is...
And he's leaving him in there, which is a little surprising.
Makes the free throw, so it's 22-14, 8-point spread. As the Bishop Luers Knights look like a half-court trap run by Homestead.
Silly foul by Homestead there.
Yep, we'll see who they call it on. Could be either Raver or Mangus, either one. As Ray Walker just split the defense.
They put that trap on last week against Dwenger, and Dwenger really had trouble with it. Now Homestead's trying to do that to Luers here.
Walker gets the ball back from Barry. Three dribbles, really nonchalant.
No Davis. Flow to Luers' offense. Barry. There's their offense. Beautiful
nice,
pass.
Nice quiet play, and they threaded the needle, and Homestead was just kind of watching the play that time.
Luers really caught Homestead napping.
Parker Mangus with the basketball. Bounce pass to Brunel. Almost got it picked. And he's on the inside, and if that's not a charge on the shot, then it's not. And a lot of people seem to think so, too.
A lot of referees behind him. And I'll tell you, Durnell can put that ball on the floor, and he's very strong at going to the basket. And sometimes that makes a difference from the referee's standpoint.
And Barry called for the personal foul on the block. That's his first foul of the ball game. And fifth foul called against the Bishop Luers Knights. Durnell makes the first free throw of two, makes it 23-16 with 3:13 to go.
He's two out of three from the foul line and missed
four.
That one. Yep.
Missed the second one, a battle between Buck and Underwood, and the basketball going to stay Homestead's end of the floor is Trey Underwood. Well, no.
Oh, now I thought he gave it
to. He pointed that way. Knights are going to have the ball. We'll take it. 3-12, down 23-16.
They were down 16-8, so they've cut into the lead a little, but they need, here comes the trap. We'll see how Luers can handle this.
Well, they got it very quickly. Barry finds J.J. Foster. He's lost to the three.
You don't want to let him alone, Kenny. He'll make them pay if you let J.J. alone.
23-19 and a full court press only till the inbounds pass comes, so they're trying to get the cheapie. Then they back off and wait.
Luers has got three threes, and that's helping them tonight.
Bounce pass to Dell, high right post. Hands it off to Parker Mangus. Mangus to Jamel. Back to Mangus. Parker. Three on the way. No good. Rebound goes long to Raver. Raver finds Buck. Buck to Ferguson. Ferguson
hasn't scored since the first quarter.
Throws it to Jamel. Jamel tries to spin.
Oh, nice move.
Two spins. Got him on the second one. Put it up and in.
He can either shoot from the outside or go inside. He's very comfortable doing both.
Foster with the basketball gives it to Underwood, who's out in between the circles. Back to Foster. Foster trying to make something happen over the top to Davis. Davis around the horn.
Oh, nice pass. Oh,
nice
good block.
Pass. Oh. Blocked in the backside. Foul on the play, I think, before he even got the shot up. They're going to say 1-1.
And that's going to hurt Homestead because now they already have 17 fouls.
2:07 on the clock here, second period action. We'll see who the foul is on, and that's called on Durnell. That's his second of the ball game.
They might have to get him out. They don't want to lose him. He's helping on offense and defense.
Trey Underwood going to strip up to the free throw line. It's important to make this front end of this one. They're down six, and he drains the first one. Now they're down five, 25-20.
Very smooth-looking shot for Trey Underwood, who looks I think he played on the offensive or defensive line for Luers, and he was very good on the football field, and he's sure playing well tonight on for the Knights and basketball here.
Second one's up. That one's brute force. Rebound pulled out of there by Durnell. Durnell finds Mangus. Mangus floats over the timeline over on the left side of the floor, picked up by Davis on the defensive side. Luers still running a tight man-to-man. Has a bounce pass to Durnell. It goes in between his feet. Underwood's got him trapped in the corner. He finds Mangus, bails him out. Davis.
Oh, nice move.
Mangus spun move, got away from him, missed the layup. Foul on the play, and going against Homestead.
I think Homestead might have been out of bounds on it, Kenny.
Out of bounds?
I think so, because I don't know if he called a...
You're right. J.J. Foster was out.
Is he back in with three fouls?
Back in with three fouls.
And Durnell's got three, and I'm surprised if I'm Luers, I go right to Barry and try to get Durnell in big foul trouble here.
And they still got him matched up with Barry. So they give the basketball to J.J. He is at the high left wing, takes a screen from Underwood. They try to.
Oh, Underwood was wide open.
Yep. Barry with a baseline shot. Ooh, way too long. Easy rebound. Here comes Homestead.
Durnell, sixth rebound.
Bounce pass to Buck. Buck drives the baseline. Barry got in his way, and they're going to call Barry.
That's two on him. They don't want to get him in foul trouble.
They call that a tack. It was ticky earlier, tack now, because that was not a lot of contact there. But Barry called for the personal. That is the sixth against Luers this half. I don't think it's going to be much of a factor with.
He's out. You're not shooting, yeah. Again, they've did a good job on Ferguson. He has he had 11 points in the first quarter, and they've held him to three.
I think, and it's early in the ball game, but it looks to me like Coach Foster is substituting Cowsey and Foster for defense offense.
To keep him out of foul trouble?
Yeah, best they can. Homestead gets it back to Ferguson. Ferguson fakes the three, tries to drive. Nobody's going to let him in there. So
Ferguson wants that outside shot, Mangus, you can tell.
Mangus to Buck. Buck's trying to get it into Durnell. No way, so they have to flip it around the shell again. You get it over to Ferguson. Ferguson, Lance launches a three. No good. A rebound, Homestead.
Homestead's getting the boards, and that's hurting Luers right now.
Offensive glass by Parker Mangus. Good job. 27-20 by the Homestead Spartans there. 53 seconds to go. I don't know if they're going to pull it back for one or just look for the best one they can get their hands on.
Davis. I would go to Barry probably. He's doing most of the scoring right now.
Bounce pass to Underwood. Underwood tries to get it to Barry. He mishandles it, so he flips it outside. Three.
Ah, there's another three from
Ray Walker.
Wow, he's got two threes.
Sam Buck gets it back to Mangus. 27-23, so it's not the runaway. The Knights are hanging in tight.
A good defense by Luers.
Stolen basketball. Threw it ahead to Barry. Barry saved it.
Good hustle, though.
And they got 24 seconds on the clock, so good hustle that time by the Bishop Luers Knights.
Well, oh, nice pass.
Gets it inside to Barry. Barry.
Oh, he's fouled. Good play by Barry. Luers is really outplaying Homestead in the second quarter.
Fouled by Buck. That'll be the eighth team foul on Homestead, and we'll see how many on Buck. That's a nice scoreboard. I like that. 16-5, second on Buck. 27-23. Nice down by four. Barry going up the line. He's got 8 points. He'd like to make it 10 here.
Luers has 8 baskets, Kenny, and 4 of them are threes. So they're doing scoring inside and out. And Antoine Barry, as you mentioned, now he has 9 points, and he's 2 out of 2 from the foul line. He makes this, and this will be the closest they've been in a long time. He can cut it to 2, and Homestead, you know, will go for that last shot.
Second one's on the way. Rattled out. No good. And Parker Mangus grabs the rebound for Homestead. 12 seconds to go. They get it down the floor to Buck quickly. Back to Mangus. Mangus hands it to Ferguson. Ferguson guarded by Walker. He's going to back up.
Ferguson will probably want to go one-on-one.
Yeah, it didn't work. Walker got him.
Oh, bad play.
Davis to launch it. Yeah, it's no good if it goes. Hit the top of the backboard anyway. So we got us an exciting one. 27-24. The Knights down by 3, but outplayed them in the second quarter. We're going to go away for about 2.5 minutes, and we'll be back with our halftime show. You're listening to Redeemer Radio on 106.3 FM, Northeast Indiana.
Successful coaches make changes to succeed by calling timeouts to make needed adjustments, for it's clear no change equals no change. This is David X with Union Savings Bank in Fort Wayne. I started mortgage lending in 1988. Since then, I've been trusted by thousands of area homeowners. I offer low closing costs and great rates on home lending, so you can save big money both up front and over the life of your loan. Make a change for the better when purchasing a different home or refinancing to lower your payment. Call timeout, get your mortgage state in hand. Call me anytime for your free mortgage checkup. And make sure you compare. Call David X, 418-6191. Member FDIC, Housing Lender.
A clean office space. Okay, that's an easy choice. And choosing the right company to clean your business is easy, too. Siokas Professional Cleaning is the choice of a lot of Fort Wayne companies because of the 100% satisfaction guarantee. Siokas does it with built-in check systems to make sure your business is cleaned beyond your expectations every time. First impressions are critical, so make sure yours is always the best with professional cleaning from Siokas. The best people, the best service. 483-2112 or online at siokas.com.
Amore's Pizza proudly supports Catholic sports. Try our Chicago-style stuffed pizza made with top-quality meats and cheeses. Your mouth will taste the difference. We also offer gluten-free options or many unique items. Amore's Pizza is located at 933 East DuPont Road, right off Coldwater. Full menu and specials can be found at amorespizza.net or call 490-9099. Amore's Pizza, where our food is made with love.
You can help support your Catholic parish or school with Notre Dame Federal Credit Union's Elevate program. You'll not only enjoy excellent personal service and save money with your new loan or credit card, you'll also be giving money back to the participating parish or school you care about. Let Notre Dame Federal Credit Union elevate all participating parishes or schools. Elevate can be reached at 844-230-6611 or visit us online at ndelevate.com. Independent from the university.
Programming on Redeemer Radio is underwritten in part by Bob Busher Homes. Floor plan customization is what they specialize in. Find floor plans, building sites, and read Bob's story on the web at bobbusherhomes.com. Bob Busher Homes is locally owned with offices in Fort Wayne and Angola. For more information about new home building or remodeling, Bob Busher Homes can be reached at 260-490-3355.
Hubcap Express is the expert in run flat tires and plus size fitment. Need your wheels straightened? Hubcap Express can fix bent wheels. For all your tire needs, visit Hubcap Express. They hang out at 606 West Coliseum Boulevard or on the web at hubcapexpress.com. 27-24, your score in the second game of the night. And they're giving them a bad time that second.
They're giving them a very bad time. And what's interesting, Kenny, Homestead has 10 baskets and 4 threes. So they got 12 points from the three-point line. Luers has got 8 baskets and 4 of them are threes. So they've got 12. Luers is 4 out of 7 from the foul line. Homestead 3 out of 5. A very, very good ball game. Antoine Barry has 9. Ray Walker has 6. J.J. Foster's got to pick it up a little. He's doing everything, but he's only got 4 points. And you know he's going to do more scoring. Jack Ferguson has 14, but they held him to one three-pointer in the second quarter. So they really slowed him down. Durnell has 6, but I think, J.J.'s got 3 fouls?
Yep.
And Durnell's got three.
Durnell's got two or three.
And so that.
Got the big scoreboard here. Let's see. Durnell is not on the board
yeah.
at this point. Oh, that didn't help any. It was a good idea, though. But, yeah, I think he's either got two or three. And Durnell, you know, the inside play is kind of interesting. Underwood is doing a good job. Durnell's big and strong and fast, but he hasn't not nearly as effective as I thought he'd be. And Barry's having a nice game. Nine with just a couple of fouls.
And I thought that Jason Davis came in and 6'5 senior did a nice job. And Bishop Luers is doing a good job. They got back in the ball game. They played a lot better. Luers had 8 points in the first quarter, and they doubled their production, Kenny. They had 16 in the second quarter, 16 for Homestead in the first quarter, and they only had 11. So Homestead really picked it up. They were down 16-8, and they've cut into it to 27-24. It's anybody's ball game, and I think Luers is finally starting to find out a little more on their offense with Foster and Walker from the outside and Barry in the inside.
Half of the first quarter, I think they're feeling each other out. Luers got out to a quick 5-1 start, and then they went, 13-0 run, Homestead did, and Luers has been fighting back ever since. Hey, Bob Hartenstein says hi.
Good.
There you go, Bob. Hey, you know, you can check out the Kyle Hyman Show. You can check out his podcast. You can find him on Google Play, iTunes, SoundCloud, and at thekylehyman.com. Check out past episodes, catch interviews you may have missed. The Kyle Hyman Show on Redeemer Radio. Let's take another 2-minute break here, and we will be back with picking off Bob's coach's brain. You're listening to Redeemer Radio on 106.3 FM.
Sperion Staffing, locally owned by the Pentenberg family, excels in finding the best candidates for industrial, clerical, customer service, non-clinical healthcare, IT, and professional direct hire placements. Sperion clients are accustomed to getting the right employees at the right time, every time. Sperion Staffing supports the proud excellence of the Dwyer Saints and the Luers Knights, both on the field and in the classroom. Whether you are seeking your next career move or searching for great employees, call us at 260-496-9900 or visit us on the web at sperion.com/ftwayne.
Hello, I'm Tom Steele with Tom Steele Tire and Auto Repair, a family-owned business for over 35 years. We carry all major brands of new tires, as well as a large selection of quality used tires to save you money. We do all types of auto repairs, be it brakes, alignment, or just fix your air conditioning. Tom Steele Tire, North Clinton or Illinois Road. Give us a try. You'll be glad you did.
Hi, sports fans. Sean McBride here, inviting you to try the barbershop experience. St. Joe Center Barbershop, located at the corner of St. Joe Center and Maplecrest, prides itself on professionalism, cleanliness, and a family-friendly atmosphere. In their third generation of family ownership, they have a combined experience of over 125 years. Give them a call at 485-6981. It's my barbershop of choice. That's St. Joe Center Barbershop at 485-6981.
Successful coaches make changes to succeed by calling timeouts to make needed adjustments, for it's clear no change equals no change. This is David X with Union Savings Bank in Fort Wayne. I started mortgage lending in 1988. Since then, I've been trusted by thousands of area homeowners. I offer low closing costs and great rates on home lending, so you can save big money both up front and over the life of your loan. Make a change for the better when purchasing a different home or refinancing to lower your payment. Call timeout, get your mortgage statement in hand. Call me anytime for your free mortgage checkup. And make sure you compare. Call David X, 418-6191. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
We're back. Bishop Luers High School got about 2 minutes before they neither team has actually come back out on the floor, so there must be a lot of strategy. So you're J.J. Foster, senior. Kids have played a pretty good second quarter. What's the advice going to the second half, Mom?
I think he's playing very good on the defensive end. He's just got to keep his son head in the ball game and not get a silly foul. Antoine Berry's doing a nice job, but they got to get more scoring. You can get Ray Walker and J.J. Foster hitting that three and driving to the bucket. You're going to have two guys that are very hard to stop, and then Barry's the third. On defense, they got to get a hand in the face all the time of Jack Ferguson. Ferguson did real well in the first quarter, and they really slowed him down. You got to watch Durnell. He can either drive to the basket. He's doing a good job of rebounding. Likes that 15-footer. But if you're Barry or Underwood, you can get Durnell in foul trouble. So Luers, I think, just got to keep playing a little better on the offensive end and they're just playing real nice. They didn't go crazy when they got way down, and they have a very good ball club. If they can get that inside-outside game going, that will really cause Homestead trouble.
Well, you're Chris Johnson, and you have the biggest run of the ball game, but things haven't gone quite your way the last 7 or 8 minutes. What do you tell your kids?
Homestead had a very good first quarter. He's got to run his offense. He's got to figure something out because they slowed Ferguson down, and they only had 4 baskets in the entire second quarter. So that really slowed down Homestead. Homestead's got to keep Durnell out of foul trouble. They got to play smart, keep playing good team basketball, but they got to get somebody besides Ferguson. Ferguson did a nice job, but they got to get somebody else scoring and besides Durnell. This Parker Mangus is a good ball player. Sam Buck hasn't scored. Homestead's got to have more overall scoring, I think, Kenny, and they got to slow down Antoine Berry or Luers could be in trouble.
Redeemer Radio is pleased to announce Redeemer Radio Odysseys, offering spiritual travel for our community. Join Father Christopher Lapp and Father Jason Freiberg on our first international pilgrimage to the Holy Land, September 9th, 11th through 19th. You know what? The football guys probably can't go. It's football season. Learn more at RedeemerRadio.com/travel. Tell you what, guys, if you want to go, call Bob and I. We'll do a game, and you guys can go to the Holy Land. Bob might want to go, too.
Homestead and Luers are back to the original starting lineups. And so here we go, Kenny. Put on that seatbelt. This should be a great third and fourth quarter.
Try not to digress. Walker, the basketball on the right wing. The man-to-man defense is not as tight as I expected it to be. They tried to get it into Berry. He doesn't have the post position. He wants to throw it to Davis. Davis launches a three from downtown. Rebound goes high in the air. Durnell pulls it out of the sky for Homestead.
He's got like 8 rebounds. He's doing a real good job on the boards.
Cycle it around to Ferguson. Ferguson's going to walk it. I mean, walk it up the floor. And he finally gets over the timeline. Started by Walker. He's over the high right wing.
They got 4 guys across the foul line, Kenny, and they're all in motion. Wow. Durnell.
It was going to be a pick and roll. Durnell didn't roll. He just stayed right there, jacked up a three, and put it in. 30.
He could do it from inside or outside.
30-24. Berry flings it over to the right side to Cowsey. Cowsey finds Davis at the top of the key. Davis looks for somebody to move. And now they're starting to move, but he flips it, has to give it up to Walker. Walker. Oh, look at that first step. That's what we talked about. Bounce past to Berry in the baseline. Goes out of bounds. Ticked out of bounds last by Homestead, but boy, Walker, he didn't get a good first step. He got 2.
You use Walker and Foster's quickness, they can make a big difference here in the, but it, again, Walker's not in there, or Foster's not in there, which he's got foul trouble.
Underwood throws a lazy over the top pass, stole by Ferguson. Ferguson just drives up, puts it up and in. He is a basketball player. He looked real comfortable doing that time.
And all of a sudden, Homestead back by 8, and Luers has got to slow down Homestead on the offensive end and get Berry on Luers' offense. Get him some looks.
32-24 as the Knights have the basketball on the offensive end of the floor. Walker puts it on his left hip, barks out some verbal instructions. Got a double high post. Everybody's really, really high, out here high. They're going to beat some back button sooner or later. But Walker just throws a great big circle and gets the basketball back. He finds Durnell. He flips it off to Davis. Davis throws it.
Oh, good rebound. Oh, and there's a foul on Durnell. Look what I found, a garbage bucket.
It landed in Barry's hands, and Durnell's hands got all mixed up with him, and Berry finished the play and put it up and in, 32-26.
Luers really needed that.
That's his third foul, so we guessed wrong early, but he's got 3 early at 6-10 here in the third quarter. Well, Berry does not complete the three-point play. Durnell pulls down the rebound, gets to Mangus. Mangus hustles down the floor, hits the brakes, and then finally gets over the timeline, guarded quickly by Davis. And he tries a spin move on Davis. Davis just stays right with him. He's not going to get away from him there. And he tried it again. Still didn't work. They give it to Buck. Buck is Demetrius rubbed off by a screen. Give it back to Grinnell. Back to Buck. They're doing all this on the right side of the floor, just outside the shell. They finally find Ferguson. Ferguson, hop, batted in the air. Walker slapped it out of his hands. Ferguson went and recovered it. Grabs it, gives it to Durnell. Durnell jacks up another three and puts it in.
He's got 2 of them from the same spot, Kenny, and all of a sudden they're back to a 9-point lead. He's hurting them inside and outside.
35-26. You scored Berry with a basketball. He's outside the arc. Throws it to Cowsey. Cowsey could have gone to the right side of the baseline, decided to go inside and ran into 3 great big tall blue guys. Has to give it up to Davis.
They need to get that ball inside to Berry and let him go work on Durnell.
And that's exactly what they did. Berry put it up too strong, got his own rebound, lost the handle on it. Walker finds it for him. And Barry calls for the basketball again. Walker drives, puts it up, teardrop, and in. Count it.
Ray Walker's got 8 points, and they're getting good scoring from Ray Walker.
35-28 to score, 5 minutes even to go here in third period action. Full-court press broken nicely by the Homestead Spartans. That press really hadn't bothered them all that much. They give it over to Durnell. Durnell scored a bunch here this third quarter. Hands it off to Mangus, back to Durnell. Underwood gets out there, gets on him, gets it inside to Ferguson. Ferguson shoots it too hard.
That's five rebounds for Antoine Berry.
Too close for him, apparently. Cousy, the freshman, thinks about driving, hits the brakes, comes back, gives it to Berry. Berry at the top of the key, flicks it over Davis, left side high. Davis is guarded by Buck. Buck's giving him some room.
Mangus is guarding Berry now.
And Buck got his hands on it, but traveled with the basketball. Davis had a pretty good angle of entry, but Buck played off of him so far, he had a chance to get at the ball.
Homestead switched Durnell on, now he's back on Berry.
Berry gets the inbound pass, gets it to Cowsey. Cowsey looking for somebody to pop back out. They do. It's Walker. Walker, look at it. He gets it. Oh, lost the basketball. Had the first step. Now he's laying on the floor. We got
nice pass.
Run under.
Wow, nice pass.
You probably heard the thud as Underwood hit the floor hard, trying to block the shot that never came out of Archibald's hands. So
I have a score from Dwenger, Kenny, at the half. Not good for Bishop Dwenger. Concordia 26 and Dwenger 16 at the half.
Oh, they'll right the ship over there. They got some good shooters in that bunch. They'll be okay. I predict that Dwenger wins still over there. Right now, 35-28. The Knights are down by 7. 42.1? There we go. That makes sense. They're playing with a clock. Got a new clock here at Bishop Luers High School.
Homestead's outscored Luers 8-4 this quarter.
Every once in a while, something goofy happens on it. Earlier they had the points and the fouls backwards on a couple of players. I'm going, okay. That's why I got Bob. Bob's the best out here anyway. I don't even know why I look at the Luers. I just look at Bob. You get it right every time. So after mopping up a little bit of Underwood sweat off the floor.
He's out there with Davis and Causey and Johnson and also Berry. Good starting lineup there for Luers.
Homestead gets it around to Ferguson. Ferguson stops and pops the three short. Didn't get his feet underneath him. Long rebound goes back to the Spartans. Ferguson drives the lane a little bit, give and go.
Ferguson is always moving, isn't he, Kenny? He never stands still.
37-28. It's a 9-point spread for Homestead. Walker beats everybody.
Oh, good move by Walker.
He is fouled going on the inside. And that's going to be definitely a two-shot foul. And I think it's going to go against Parker Mangus, the senior, the 6'3 senior. You know, he looks bigger than 6'3. And I'm wrong. It's Archibald. His third foul of the ball game. Second foul on Homestead this half.
Walker has 8 points, and right now, if he can use his quickness, they can get back into this game and possibly win this because Homestead does not have any answer for Walker's quickness.
Buck down Raver in. They give up about 3 inches there. Homestead does. Walker made the first free throw. Second one flies. He's a left-hander, puts it up and in.
He's got 10 points.
37-30. Again, Luer is going to pressure the inbounds pass, and then they back it off. Although Walker's trying to keep Ferguson from even touching the basketball. He's going to try and do some denying, which worked well in the second quarter. Parker Mangus with the basketball left wing high. Gets it around to Raver.
Barry's guarding Raver. I'm not sure what that's about.
Archibald to Durnell. Durnell to Mangus. Mangus bounce pass. Nice give and go.
Oh, good pass and no good.
Didn't finish. Durnell rolled it around the iron. And Underwood took the basketball and said, give me that. Right off the glass. Whistle stops.
Archibald does no quickness at all for Archibald. And now Luers is going to put in Foster, and that should be a big help.
Yeah, Walker just out hustled Archibald. That's Archibald's fourth foul of the ball game.
He's coming out, isn't he?
Yeah, and Logan Pauley, the 5'10 guard. So they're going to lose some height there, but gain some experience. I think Walker's going to trigger the basketball into Berry. They hand it back to Walker. Walker
can still use his quickness there.
He likes to put it on his left hip. He's guarded by Pauley, and he's thinking about it. Oh, I got Pauley going the wrong way, and he is fouled on the way in. That's probably going to be Mangus. And they're going to give him two shots on that one. Whoa, that's kind of liberal.
And Walker's footprints were right there. He's two out of two from the foul line. 10 points. All of a sudden he hits this, and they're back to five and right in the ball game. Homestead's hit a low on the offensive end all of a sudden.
3:18 on the clock. He hits the front end of the two-shot foul. 37-31 your score. It's the 11th point for number 11. and Ray Walker is,
setting up maybe the defensive assignments?
Well, I don't know. Either that or he's playing on a rebound. And no rebound on that because it went in.
Walker's taking over right now. If J.J. Foster can join the scoring brigade, Luers could definitely win this ball game. Ooh, oh, that was a pop.
Well, yeah, it looked like it. They're definitely trying to deny Ferguson the basketball. They got it to Pauly Logan, Logan to Brunell. Brunell flips it over to Grant Raber, and he finds Ferguson. Ferguson is really guarded close by Walker. He dumps it down inside Brunell. He's working on Underwood.
Boy, Durnell's tough, isn't he, Kenny?
Yep, he got baseline position that time. Got established this turn.
He's got 14 points.
39-32 the score, 2:51 here for a period. And Walker with a basketball guarded by Logan Pauly. Walker looking for somebody to come out and set a screen for him. He does. They do a quick switch. They got a big-time mismatch inside of Underwood, but they switched back now. Here comes Walker.
Another foul.
Walker caught him on the switch and hustled past Pauly Logan. Or Logan Pauly, excuse me. Not nice when you have two first names.
And what's really going to hurt Homestead, that's five fouls, five team fouls.
He gets one for Bishop Luers. I'm surprised the crowd hasn't started squawking about it a little bit.
Walker's four out of four from the foul line, and he's five, and he's single-handedly shooting Bishop Luers right back into the game.
We don't want to jinx him.
Jalen Causey's back in one. For Bishop Luers. They're back to small with Davis and Barry and three little guards.
39-33. The second one is rattled.
You're right, Kenny.
Pops out.
Darn it.
On it.
Eight Durnell. Or nine rebounds for Durnell besides his good scoring.
Gets it forward to Ferguson. Ferguson stops in his tracks. And the ball gets loose. Mangus picks it up. Flings it to the right side to Logan Pauly. Pauly outside to Grant Raber. Raber trying to get beat the freshman. He picks it
good
up.
Good defense by Luers.
Finally gets it into Ferguson. Ferguson loses the handle. They're going to put a foul on somebody. It's three Luers.
That's only two team fouls on Luers this half. They've done a nice job.
Ferguson got established on the right mid post. Spun to his right and got inside. The help side defense really came into play there. But, Ray Walker picked up his first foul of the ballgame. Ferguson gets it, drives the baseline, got Walker out of position, puts it up and in.
He's always looking for the offense, no doubt. Ferguson's just an offensive-minded, good-looking ball player.
41-33, your score, Walker with a basketball. Right wing gets to Foster out in between the circle. Quickly guarded by Pauly. Foster got around him quick, put up a kind of a sideways teardrop. It didn't go. Rebound Durnell. They give it to Ferguson. Hard to deny him when he brings the basketball up, so Walker's going to pick him up right at the timeline. Floats to the left side with him. Ferguson tries to spin move, and Walker lost his footing. Ferguson put up a layup, missed the thing. Barry comes down with a rebound. Haven't heard much from Barry this quarter. Walker caught the defense. Oh, my. Caught the defense flat-footed. The last guy to save the layup was Grant Raber, and Raber just shoved him. He could almost make a case for an intentional foul there. And that was kind of late.
This will be seventh and eighth foul shots this quarter. Not for the game, but this quarter. Walker has already shot, after these two hills, shot 10. He's made 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He's making a living at the foul line.
And he puts the first one in, makes the score 41-34, and it's $1.28. 1:28 on the clock here, third quarter action.
As Kenny mentioned, good coaching by J.J. Foster. His son plays on the offensive end, and they take him out on the defensive end. And Tyrone Hambright, I don't think we've seen him in there yet.
Nope. Second free throw is good, so we're back to a six-point ball game. And we're going to stay with full court pressure this time instead of relaxing it. So a different look. Bounce pass forward to Raver. Raver throws it way over the top of the front.
You don't want to leave him open.
Catch and shoot. Hits the front of the iron. Tipped out. And Logan Pauly grabs it. He's slinging around to Durnell. Durnell's going to drive the lane. Barry.
Oh, boy, is he tough. Is he tough or what?
Durnell made a nice offensive move. Barry did everything he could except knock him flat. Ball went in. So 43-35 with 1:09 in the third. Home set up by 8.
16 points for Durnell and a ton of rebounds.
So everybody's happy. Everybody on the rebounding line. Durnell eyes the free throw. Hits the front of the iron. No good. Rebound Homestead.
Oh, nice block.
By Barry, or by Davis. They get it outside to Ferguson.
He drives, what a pass.
Dumps it
what
off.
A pass.
Dumps it off to Durnell. Durnell puts it up and in. So that's a four-point trip down the floor for Homestead.
All of a sudden, Homestead's back by 10, Kenny, when Luers was right in the ballgame.
45-35, we're inside a minute, 48 and counting. Ray Walker again direct a little bit of traffic. This time everybody's down on the baseline.
And they couldn't get J.J. Foster in to run the offense, so he probably won't get in here in these last 30 seconds.
Walker Grant guarded by Raver.
Boy, he just threw that up, didn't he?
Well, he beat him up there, but he got off balance, but slung it up and it went in. 45-37.
He's got 17 points.
23 seconds to go, and they got him trapped in the corner. And the timeout called by Homestead's Coach Johnson saved them a possession there.
And that was almost close to 10 seconds, I bet.
Yeah, they were working close. 30-second break. We'll take one, too. You're listening to Redeemer Radio. 106.3 FM, Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
Hey, sports fans. Listen to who just scored again. John Sullivan with Remax. Buying a home or selling yours? You need the best coach around. Score with John Sullivan at Remax. Score with John. Call Remax and ask for John Sullivan to coach you in buying a home or selling yours. Sports fans, it's time to score with John Sullivan at Remax.
Homestead going to take the ball out of bounds on the far side right in front of the Luers bench, and they're greeted by a lot of full court pressure. They get it in to Mangus. Davis let him go by, and he flipped it right away to Walker. He's having a great third quarter. Walker takes it back to the iron, shot blocked. He got the rebound after a big mess. Rebound to Luers.
That was a good idea.
No look to Barry, and Barry just couldn't quite get the handle on it. Jalen Charlton checked it or no. Get the number off it. Tell that young man to turn so I can see his number. Yeah, that is Tyrene Hambright checked in the lineup for Bishop Luers. Ferguson beats the freshman by the floor. Hambright picked up the basketball and the time runs out. So interesting last 21 points.
We're going to have quite a fourth quarter, people.
I'm ready to go. 45-37. Let's take a 1 minute break. Redeemer Radio, 106.3 FM, Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
Are you looking for an orthopedic specialist? Ortho Northeast has been serving the community for over 50 years with offices in three convenient locations. Look for the location nearest you. Dr. John Pritchard is a board-certified orthopedic surgeon with 20 years of experience with OMP and can assist you with the best treatment plan for your knee or shoulder pain. Dr. John Pritchard is looking forward to meeting you and helping with all orthopedic needs. Call Dr. Pritchard at 260-484-8551 or visit the web at www.orthone.com.
Hello, sports fans. This is Father Bob Garrow, chaplain at Bishop DeWanger High School. It is time to get geared up for our fall sports season. Whether competing on the soccer field, golf or cross-country course, volleyball court, or on the gridiron, we wish good luck and great sportsmanship to all our student athletes and their teams. May we become the saints we are called to be. Saint Sebastian, pray for us.
And we're back with the fourth quarter of one of the best ball games we've seen this year. Homestead up 45-37.
Kenny, I got a Dwenger's correction. As Kenny was right, 31-17 Dwenger over Concordia at the half.
I knew they'd write the ship. Coach Kostoff and the crew over there doing
for Homestead, 20 points for Ferguson, 18 for Durnell. So they got 38 points. Walker's got 17, and Barry's got 11.
Mangus long inbound pass to Buck. Buck was,
and now there's a foul.
See what Foster did, though? Buck went to lean on him. Foster stepped back. Buck fell on his backside. And to recover the basketball, Homestead fouled somebody.
And this is big for Homestead. They got 17 fouls. Luers has only got three. And J.J. Foster at the foul line, he's one out of two. Oh, I'm sorry, Antoine Berry. And Antoine Berry is two out of four. So we need to make these and cut into the lead.
He's probably itching because he hasn't scored much in the third quarter here. So. And he had a nice first half.
That was only his third point. You're exactly right.
So with 4 seconds gone in the fourth, 45-38, Barry to the second free throw line. I still like the defense by Foster just backed up, let Buck fall down. Missed the second.
Barry's got 12 points for the game, and Luers cut it to seven.
Three rebounding machine. Grinnell pulls it down, gets it to Mangus. Mangus to Grinnell, back to Mangus, over to the right side to Raver. Raver tries to dribble right, gets cut off by the defense.
Homestead will be in no hurry here. They'll run their offensive set and look for a good shot.
They got Ferguson down on the inside, and the Hambrights guarding him. Hambright hasn't been in the ball game all that long. We'll see kind of mean little defense he could put on Ferguson for a while. They give it to Grinnell on the switch. Grinnell's picked up by Berry. He gets to the inside looking for something to give it up to. He gives it up to Mangus. Mangus back to Grinnell. Up and under move. Berry got caught.
I'll tell you, has he practiced that move or what, Kenny? He just automatic with that move, and that gives him 20 points.
The freshman, Cosley, launches a three. It goes long. Raver with the rebound for Homestead. Cosley steals it back.
He made up for that mistake.
Well, another possession for the Bishop Luers Knights. Walker jumping up and down on the other side of the court, but everybody saw him that time. Barry's calling for it.
Walker wants to go one-on-one.
He's got Parker Mangus on him, and he lost Mangus, but the defense.
Man, Walker's having a career night. He's really having a good one.
He stopped and threw it over Durnell. Nice little teardrop shot.
He's got 19. We mentioned Homestead would not have an answer for the quickness of Walker or Foster.
Basketball to the top of the key. Now Buck has it left side, gets it down inside. Raver puts the move on the freshman Cowsey, and the whistle stops for his shot. Did not go in, but I do believe they're going to call the young Mr. Jalen Cowsey for his first foul of the ball game. That's the fourth foul on Luers, and they're going to go to the strike for two.
Homestead has only shot six all night. This is their seventh and eighth free throws.
47-40, the score, 6:30 on the clock. First free throw looks like I shot it. No good.
Coach Johnson does not like that when you have the lead and the clock is stopped. You need to make all the points you can.
That was interesting. They didn't let the sub come in. And we got a little discussion over on the Luers bench with the referee and J.J. Foster. But I don't know why.
Jake Archibald, I think he's got four fouls. I don't know why he did. Oh, Kenny, they must have given
violation.
Yes, I didn't.
I missed it myself.
I did too.
That's why they didn't let him in.
And that could hurt Luers because Luers could have got the ball, and now they're down eight and possibly down nine.
48-40 is far on the lane violation.
Archibald's in there with four.
Raver got an extra crack at it.
If I'm Luers, I take it right at Archibald and try to foul him out.
He makes the second free throw, up by nine, 49-40. The Knights have to get going here. And timeout?
Wow.
No? Whistle stops play. Oh, the clock did not take off. Clock didn't go.
They're having trouble, as you mentioned, with the new scoreboard, it looks like.
Well, new scoreboard comes with new controls. And I have been on that side of the world. I don't play with the scoreboard, but I've been with the guys, and we try to correct them and stuff.
And Luers is making some subs here. I'm not real sure where we're at. Causey, I know, is coming back in, and so is Alex Neer, the 6-foot senior, and trying to see who's on the. Oh, they got
Foster.
We're real
Walker,
small, aren't they?
Barry, Neer,
three guards, Barry, and. Oh, they're going to call continuation.
That didn't go in, but he's going to get two shots at the free throw line. He shot a ton of free throws. Obviously, he's been told to drive. And they're going to call that foul against Grant Raver. Walker going to stroll to the free throw line. It's got to be a double digit shooting free throws this quarter.
I know. I tried to count him up real quick, but I think he's just having a real good ball game. He's got 19 points.
We're running out of room in that third quarter, Colin.
These are the ninth and tenth free throws he shot.
And he makes it.
And again, his shooting and the free throws are keeping Luers close in this game. A lot of foul shots for Luers, not very many for Homestead.
49-41 your score. And they got the clock fixed. It says 6:22 left in regulation. Second free throw up and good. And Mr. Walker drains a pair. Makes it 49-43.
And he has 21 points.
6:18 and counting. Token press. Broken by the Homestead Spartan.
Oh, good steal. Oh, look at that hustle. What hustle.
And he had his foot on the out-of-bounds line, but he flipped it straight in here. We were with the Homestead anyway, but Walker getting into their head a little bit, disrupting the offense before the offense even gets going. But Ray Walker's had a great game.
And his quickness is starting to really wear on Homestead. Homestead's having trouble here.
Grinnell gives it to Mangus. Mangus.
Oh, what a move.
Trying to run over somebody. They're going to call.
Are they calling a pop? Oh, they're calling a foul on, wow.
On Mangus.
I thought that looked like a pretty good move.
Goes against Homestead. And he backdoored somebody and knocked him flat.
Causey's going to play on offense and on defense, and Nair's going to play on offense.
Walker, ooh, he just carried it. You better be careful. Bring the basketball up over the timeline. Floats to the right side. J.J. Foster front of the baseline. Nair
Homestead's going to run a zone, Kenny. Let's see if this helps slow down Walker. They're into a zone.
Foster's looking at it. This is the Barry. Barry's going to drive, walked. And he traveled with the basketball. 49-42, your score, 5:47. And Cousy back in the lineup from here.
5:47, Mark. Homestead went to the zone. We'll see if that slows down, especially on the fouling.
Homestead triggers the basketball in. Pressure. Well, they tried to double team him on the back side of the sideline. Didn't work. Grinnell's got it over the corner. Swing it around the shell. Raber to Mangus. Mangus to Grinnell.
A mismatch.
And slapped out of his hands. And Barry almost got it, but he had to go out of bounds to go get it. Good hands on the inside that time. I think it was J.J. Foster.
And I was just going to say a mismatch. J.J. Foster trying to guard Durnell, but it worked in J.J.'s favor that time.
Durnell gets the inbound pass, hands it back to Ferguson. Ferguson floating down the three-point line. Goes inside the lane, puts it up, running around. No good. Rebound, Walker.
Here comes Luers, and Walker's quick.
Walker gets it in the corner to Foster. Foster launches a three, count it.
That's what J.J. does. He's only got 4 points. Now he's got seven. And again, all of us, we're in a ball game, and Coach Johnson cannot be happy if you're Homestead right now.
49-45, your score. They break the press, not very easily. Get it into Ferguson on the secondary break, and he is fouled as he goes to the iron. Tyrene Hambright. Oh, no foul on the play. Clean block. Clean block by Hambright, who is getting some playing time here in the important sections of the ballgame. 5:02.
Ferguson has not scored this quarter, Kenny, and that's really slowed down Homestead.
Oh, a little bit nice little back cut that time by Mangus. Put it up and in easy.
They caught Luers snapping that time. Yeah, and now Luers, what?
Well, Luers tried to bring it inbound.
And did he step over?
Well, he didn't get out of bounds. He just took it, flipped it in. So a dumb turnover.
Durnell and Ferguson have 20 points apiece.
Ferguson.
Now he's waking up. He's got 23.
That's a 5-point trip down the floor. 54-45 now. That's twice now the Luers Knights.
And again, the zone for
Walker.
He's having a great game.
54-47. Again, the full court press put on not real aggressively as Archibald just dribbles right through it. They try to double team him as he picks up the basketball. But, a good passing game of the Homestead Spartans prevents that.
Homestead almost forced that pass.
Yeah, they had that. Ferguson ran the baseline. He just about lost handle on it. They finally get it out to Raver. Raver's going to try and pick a roll with Grinnell. Raver stops, pops, wide right. Rebound for Walker.
That was not a good shot for Homestead.
Walker. J.J.'s going to go in amongst the trees.
Oh, what a pass. What a pass. Luers is really in this ball game, and Coach Johnson, I bet if there's one more basket, Johnson will call timeout because the momentum has really switched to Luers.
54-49, basketball in Ferguson's hands. He's high right wing. He's got a dribble to use up. He does. He's guarded closely by Hambright.
Ferguson or Durnell's going to do the shooting.
Durnell shot it and put it in.
This kid is having a great game. How about 23 points for him and Ferguson?
3:41 on the clock. Walker drives again. This time he kicks it out of Hambright. Hambright throws up.
I don't think that's his shot.
And the rebound, Raver for Homestead. 3:31 and an 8-point lead. I'm surprised Homestead.
There's a silly turnover by Homestead.
Parker Mangus's hands. Mangus wasn't really ready for it.
Coach Johnson's just shaking his head. He had an 8-point lead and the ball, and they threw it away. Kenny, they keep sending hot dogs passes. I'm starting to get hungry here. They're giving them away. And I got my hand up, but they think I'm trying to get in the game or something.
Most likely, I'm going to catch them.
No ketchup, no mustard. I don't want those.
Walker over the timeline. Double high post offense to give it over to Foster. Foster takes the pick, stops at the free throw line, puts it up and in.
That's too easy. You can't let J.J. Foster shoot from there. He'll drill it every time.
57-51, 3:05 on the clock. Again, token pressure by the Luers Knights. broken easily by the passing game of the Homestead Spartans. They swing around to Shell Raver with a basketball guarded by Walker.
They got to slow down Ferguson and Durnell.
Durnell guarded by Barry. They do a switch. Durnell,
he's got to miss one of these.
And he did. He missed it. Basketball hits two guys in the head. And finally, J.J. Foster comes up. Oh, he palmed it too. Underwood throws it in the corner near. Near looks for somebody. Ball got tapped, but pulled out of there by J.J. He gets over near. Near throws a three up. Hits the back of the iron. No good.
Oh, Ferguson, good try by Near, though. That's all right. Nobody hurt on that foul.
Near went inside to follow your shot, the old adage. But Ferguson happened to be in his way. And as soon as Ferguson turned around, Near was
I think they're going to bring Causey back in for Nair.
Yep, they do. They've been doing that offense-defense substitution, and there's a timeout on the floor by Bishop Luers. They're taking a one-minute break. So are we. Virginia Radio, 106.3 FM, in Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
You can help support your Catholic parish or school with Notre Dame Federal Credit Union's Elevate program. You'll not only enjoy excellent personal service and save money with your new loan or credit card, you'll also be giving money back to the participating parish or school you care about. Let Notre Dame Federal Credit Union elevate all participating parishes or schools. Elevate can be reached at 844-230-6611 or visit us online at ndelevate.com. Independent from the university.
Tri-State Warehousing is one of the most complete service-oriented companies in the warehousing field today. Located in Fort Wayne, Tri-State Warehousing is a 50,000 square foot dry and temperature-controlled storage facility serving two-thirds of the continental U.S. with overnight rail service. The dedicated staff and specialty services of Tri-State Warehousing are known throughout the industry. For great things in store, call Tri-State Warehousing, 260-436-2010. That's 260-436-2010.
Kenny, one of the reasons Luers is back in the game, they have made 14 out of 20 foul shots. Homestead shot 7 all night and made 5. But Luers is really going to the line because they're a lot more aggressive than Homestead.
57-51, your score. Homestead up by 6. 2:31 left in regulation. Homestead has the basketball. And the Luers Knights set up a full court.
Luers needs a turnover.
And easily broken again by Homestead. They try to the secondary break, and it works to perfection, except they missed the first one and rebound and up.
Parker Mangus has 6 points, but that was as big a point as he'll have the whole night.
Offensive glasswork. Walker launches the
That's three. A long one.
No good. Barry skies in between three. Homestead Spartans.
He's been quiet, but he finally got back in the scoring column.
And he does some work on the offensive glass. So. And a steal by Walker.
Oh, I thought that's no good. There's another foul. Homestead right just out. Gave it to him there.
Took it right out of Ferguson's hand and put it up, and Ferguson had to foul him. And Walker, he's got footprints at that free throw line. He's going right back to the same spot. 59-53, Luers down by 6, 2:02 on the clock. It stopped, and Walker to the free throw line.
He's 9 out of 10. This will be 11 and 12 foul shots. He's had more foul shots than the entire Homestead team. He's now 10 out of 11. He makes this, Kenny. They're down 4 with 2 minutes to go, and it's anybody's game.
And the left-hander throws it up. Looks good from here, and it is.
And here comes the pressure. Homestead's got to have to figure out what they want to do.
59-55, 2 minutes each.
Oh, they almost stole that one.
Mangus gets it to Ferguson first. Got four defenders around him. He finally throws it back out, and they pull it back out wisely. Raver bounce pass to Durnell. Darnell guarded by Causey. There's a huge mismatch. Better get that fixed.
Homestead's in no hurry here.
And shouldn't be. Parker Mangus scribbles it around a little bit, gives it over to Raver. Raver back to Mangus. Mangus guarded by the freshman. The freshman will try to reach in from the backside and slap it away.
Only 16 fouls on Luers.
Yep, so that was one to give, and probably a good one to give here at 138. It's only his second foul of the ball game, so the freshman playing a pretty clean game.
Luers' quickness, especially Foster and Walker, they need a turnover because they're awful quick.
Raver throws it deep into the backcourt to Mangus. Mangus is guarded by the freshman again. They're going to try and take that mismatch. Mangus blew by him that time. Something happened.
They called it. Wow, I don't know. I thought it was a basket, but I thought maybe they called it something else.
Talk about an NBA continuation play. My, oh, my. That was a long one. Hakowski tried to reach.
Mangus
got beat defensively. He did it again. He tried to reach from the backside, and he took two steps before he got to the iron. So J.J. Foster arguing well. Missed the free throw, so it's 61-55. And J.J. brings it up, throws a three up from the parking lot.
I don't know if they needed that one.
Rebound, Homestead. Homestead gets it forward to Ferguson. Ferguson, a head fake, gets past the defenders. He's going to drive the lane, put it up.
Oh, my. Look at it. All of a sudden, Homestead is waking up again on the offensive end.
Well, they've got two pretty lucky breaks down on the inside. That time, Ferguson got through three people. And the last time, Brunell, or Manga should have never even got that bucket. So.
Exactly.
63-55, your score with 117.
25 for Ferguson, 23 for Jurnell. They have 48 points between them, and Luers has 55 for a team.
Ferguson puts it in, so it's 9 points. It's been an ugly 47 seconds for Bishop Luers.
Boy, did that turn around.
Walker gives it to Foster. Foster drives it in the lane like
Walker. Oh, nice pass.
Dump pass to Berry. Berry puts it up and in.
Luers got to get. Luers need a turnover here. They got to put on the pressure.
104. They get over the timeline. Double bounce pass for Brunell. Brunell kind of laughs at it when he gets it. Picks it up. Hands it over to Raver. Raver gets outside, and Berry just fouls him firmly.
Probably a good guy to foul. He is 3 out of 3 from the foul line, but he's not one of the offensive juggernauts, Kenny. So. Even though he's made 3 out of 3, you got to just take your chances.
That's Berry's fifth foul of the ballgame.
Oh, boy.
18 points and 5 fouls. Pretty good night for Antoine Berry. Most of his damage is done in the first half. They've kind of negated in the second half, but he has made a little bit of noise offensively.
As you said, 18 points and a lot of rebounds for Antoine. Big free throws here.
Grand Raver puts it up and in. 65-57. 56.3 left in regulation.
Raver had 3 points in the entire first half. Kenny, in this last minute, he scored three himself. So he's got 3 big points when Homestead really needed them. Homestead looked like they were in a little trouble.
Second one is up and good. 66-57, 9 points. Foster needs to get down the floor quickly. And let's get a bucket early.
Foul. There's a silly foul on Homestead.
That's not what you do when you're in the lead like that. They reached in the foul, and that's the 10th foul. So we're going to shoot two with the clock stop. That foul is going to go against the Parker Mangus. It's his fourth. And J.J. Foster is going to stomp into the old footprints that Walker has put in there.
For Luers, 25 points for Walker, but everybody else on the floor only has 9 right now for Luers.
It rattled home. Didn't look pretty, but it went in. 66-58. And we're changing bodies here on the rebounding line. Hambright's going to go back and play some defense.
Luers not real big out there right now with Berry fouled out. And they actually got 3 guards out there again.
And second one is smooth as glass.
They need pressure. They need pressure here and quickness.
They got a lot of it. They give it to Ferguson. Ferguson waves everybody off. And the double team comes quickly. Walker bangs into him and probably needed to. Can't let that clock burn up anymore. 46.4, and the Knights are down by 7. Got to hope that Ferguson loses his touch here. Ferguson has had a heyday. He's got 26.
And
tonight.
1 from the foul line. That's it. 1 out of 1.
And the first one goes in. So it's 67-59.
Again, 50 points between Ferguson and Durnell.
Second free throw is going to fly here. It's up and good. Whistle stops play. Timeout on the floor. We'll take a 30-second break ourselves. You're listening to SAC Basketball. Redeemer Radio 106.3 FM, Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend, and diamonds are forever. And since 1988, Peter Franklin has been bringing you the finest diamonds imported from overseas diamond cutters. Peter Franklin Jewelers. Jewelry created from concept to completion by our master goldsmiths on staff. Peter Franklin Jewelers, with 3 locations to serve you. New Haven, DuPont Road, and Angola. Remember, it's not just jewelry, it's Peter Franklin.
46.4 on the clock, 68-59. Homestead on top by 9.
Homestead has scored 23 points this quarter, and Luers has scored 22, but it was 68-59 now, and it was 45-37 going into the fourth quarter. Homestead's outscored them by 1.
Underwood going to take the basketball out the far end of the court. Walker lets it bounce, but he's going sideways, so that didn't help him any. Clock started. They get it to Foster. Foster kind of floats around looking for the three, decides to drive. They let him go in there, put it up and in.
Good move by JJ. He's having a great fourth quarter.
68-61, 33 seconds. They're having trouble getting it in. They do. Full court press all over Buck in the basketball.
Oh, there's a steal by Foster. There's a foul, but nope.
Foul, they didn't call it. That foul they're going to call.
Hey, Jay, Luers, with JJ shooting foul shots, Luers still got a chance, and Coach Johnson's very disappointed in the turnovers here in the last 2 minutes.
24.2 on the clock, 68-61. Your score and two shots coming for J.J. Foster. He's been pretty dead eye at the line here the last couple times he's been to the line.
J.J.'s got 13 points. He can add to it right now.
And hits the front of the iron and short.
And I was just going to say, he's the one, besides Walker, you want him at the foul line. Walker's been quiet all of a sudden, hadn't he, Kenny?
Well, they changed defenses, and they're trying to deny Walker the basketball.
And let J.J. go a little more.
Yeah, he's got a little more air.
Oh, boy, that really hurt.
Well, no good. They hand the rebound off to Ferguson. Ferguson falls down. They're having trouble getting the basketball over the timeline. They finally do. Boy, they were about out of time. 14
seconds. Oh, my, he went right to the basket.
Up and in, 70-61, and this is going to be over with 10 seconds.
Mangus got 6 points this quarter.
J.J. hasn't given up, puts up a shorty. Walker with a rebound. He puts it up. No good. Rebound. Homestead 2 seconds to go, and that's going to be your ball game.
Impressive Homestead victory after they were struggling there for a while.
70-61 at kind of a non-exciting final minute there. We thought it was going to get crazy, but with a couple of quick, fast breaks by Homestead and a couple easy buckets late, the last three buckets they made were all layups. So they just out-hustled everybody late in the ballgame. 70-61, your final score. Let's take a one-minute break. We'll be back with our post-game show. You're listening to Redeemer Radio on 106.3 WRDF, Columbia City, Northeast Indiana.
Redeemer Radio gladly thanks Dr. Mark Stoner, a St. Jude parishioner, for underwriting a portion of our programming. Dr. Stoner offers comprehensive dentistry for every family member. Dr. Stoner can be found at 9830 Auburn Road. For more information regarding all your dental needs, it can be found on the web at markstonerdds.com or at 260-484-4181.
Successful coaches make changes to succeed by calling timeouts to make needed adjustments. For it's clear, no change equals no change. This is David X with Union Savings Bank in Fort Wayne. I started mortgage lending in 1988. Since then, I've been trusted by thousands of area homeowners. I offer low closing costs and great rates on home lending, so you can save big money both up front and over the life of your loan. Make a change for the better when purchasing a different home or refinancing to lower your payment. Call timeout, get your mortgage statement in hand. Call me anytime for your free mortgage checkup. And make sure you compare. Call David X, 418-6191. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
And we're back, basketball fans. Post-game show, Redeemer Radio, 70-61, your final score. Homestead puts the finishing touches. They finished the ball game quickly with three layups in the last minute and a half to salt this one away, but not till Luers give them quite a scare. And, Bob, I was somewhat surprised at the lack of turnovers by Homestead because they responded to the pressure pretty well.
They did, and we really thought, especially with the three little guards in there. Kenny, what was interesting, 24 points for Luers in the first half, and Homestead had 27. But Homestead outscored Luers 43-37 in the second half. And between Durnell with 23 and Ferguson with 28, they only had four guys score the entire game. Two of them had 51, and then Mangus, a quiet 12. So you had four guys doing all the scoring, and then for Luers, Barry had 18, but they slowed him down, didn't they?
Yeah, they sure did. He had a big first half. Second half, he got some of his points, but he got them late. Not insignificant, but if he could have stayed effective offensively in the third quarter, I think it would have been a different ballgame.
And again, you made a good point on that also. I thought with Antoine Barry, he had 9 points, 9 in the first, 9 in the second half. But I thought with Durnell in foul trouble, Barry would have a field day. He had 18. If it wasn't for Ray Walker, I don't know if it would have been this close. Ray Walker had 25 points. And hard to believe, I'm looking at my chicken scratching here. He had 6 points in the first half.
Yeah, he
and
came
they were
alive.
And they were both threes, and he came back with 19.
Yeah, he came alive. I think he got specific instructions from Coach Foster to get in the lane and drive. And he hit the teardrop, I don't know, four or five times.
And his free throws, defense. He just, I mean, again, we've watched him all year and last year, and we said how quick he is, and it took him a while to use his quickness. But once he started going to the basket, and if you get J.J. Foster doing the same thing and Barry scoring in the inside, Luers is going to be tough for anybody the rest of the year.
Tough night for both teams in the Bishop Luers night. We thought this could happen, but, you know, we still got to play the games, and you just never know what's going to happen. We're going to point out to the IPFWIU game all year long. That's why we play the games even if we think they're...
And Homestead's a very good team. They play good team. And the thing that was interesting, even though they had four guys that did all the scoring, they're really team basketball. They pass the ball around, set a lot of picks. And the Ferguson kid, he just had a wonderful game. And, again, when you have two guys scoring 51 points, 51 of the 70. But, again, your key, I think, was very important. We thought for sure Luers would have a lot of points off of turnovers. And if the press bothered Homestead, it wasn't that evident tonight.
No, they have a very good passing game. They get kids in the spots on the floor where they need to be. And Luers didn't really press till late. And when I say press, they would badger the inbounds pass, sort of. They didn't challenge a pass, and they let it come in relatively easily, and then they'd back off the press and go back to the half-court defense. And I thought that was kind of odd because they didn't try to run a half-court trap. They didn't try to run a three-quarter court trap. They just not exactly sure what they were trying to accomplish, but maybe slow down Homestead to not get into their offensive flow quite as easy. Didn't seem to make a whole heck of a lot of difference.
And the two big things with Homestead, if you watch them all year, they're always moving on offense and against the press or whenever they're running, their heads up. Whoever's got the ball, their heads up looking for the open man. And I'll tell you, they sure pass that ball and share it. And that's a big reason why they had the 70-61 victory.